Check the vibe. Styles upon styles upon styles is what I have. You want to diss the Phife, but you still don't know the half. I sport New Balance sneakers to avoid the narrow path. Mess around with this, you catch a size 8 up your. I never half step, cause I'm not a half stepper. Drink a lot of soda, so they call me Dr. Pepper. Refuse to compete with BS competition. Your name ain't special ed, so won't you settle with the mission? I never walk the streets thinking it's all about me. Even deep down in my heart, it really could be. I just try my best to like go all out. Some might even say, yo, shorty black. This is just one of the prolific verses that come from 5 albums deep of hip hop royalty. Do you understand what those 5 albums did for the world? I have conversations with people day in and day out who always tell me you wrote the soundtrack to my life. So tonight what we gonna do is we gonna celebrate my man. And if you see me cry, it's because I really miss that dude. The first and only black man to ever serve in the office of mayor in the great city we call New York City. Your man says it time and time again, Kirk. He says, Mr. Dickens, will you please be my mayor? Ladies and gentlemen, Mayor David Norman Dickens, get up.
But it should be no surprise that my favorite is Can I Kick It? Yes, you can. Mr. Dickens, would you please be my mayor? Leek and his music stood by us. He showed tremendous courage battling his health challenges for more than 2 decades. It's true that we have no power over death, but we do have power over life. Power to live it to its fullest. And so today, as we mourn the loss of Malik, let us also celebrate a life well lived. Malik's death gives us reason to mourn, but his life gave everyone so much more to celebrate. I can say that I was always proud to be your mayor.
Put your hands together for Chuck D, Joe Barber, that buster.
Salute the dignity of hip hop and the salute the honesty of Phife's life. I mean, his rhymes were honest. He had to be honest, and he was honest since 1992. We all rode with Phife and his struggle. All the fans and the whole entire world, because he let everybody know this is what I'm going through. And he kept it real and he kept it rhyme. One thing I remember the most out of Phife, as he melded and melted the hip hop and the sports world together that sports didn't pick up on as well as they should have, did the Bo Jackson rhyme. Bo knows this, Bo knows that.
Bo don't know Jack.
Bo don't know Jack, but
Bo can't rap.
If I can honestly speak without prejudice, I never lived my life with the concept of dying one day. I don't live my life like that. So, even though we understand that, death is a part of the most amazing design our plans, which is God. I don't know what to call it. That's one thing that I never grew to like an idea of. And I love God a lot. But I don't like that thing. When you love, a lot the person who dies. I don't got but I don't have all the brothers. He was like my father. He gave me my name. He gave our group, and this is a new school, our name. So he was more like dad than big bro. And he was big bro too. But my big brothers was leaders of the new school and tribe. Literally, because I'm younger than all of them. But I tell this story all the time because it's one of the proudest moments of my life. And my life was changed significantly when I got with Tribe and Leaders. So, you fast forward past all the becoming leaders and meeting Tribe and wanting to be like Tribe. They had four members in the group, Leaders had four members in the group. Three of the dudes rhymed, two of them was more prominent MCs than the third MC. And that was me and Brian, and me competitive. Try to outdo each other, like how it always sounded like Phife and Q-Tip was always respectively competing. Keep each other sharp, keep each other up, keep each other powerful. And then goes Jerobe. And ironically, as time came to pass, Dinko started becoming more and more dangerous with his pen. So it was those moments where where it wasn't about me and Brown. Just like Jerome had moments where it wasn't really about Phife and Q-Tip. That forced us to keep our blades even sharper and want to step it up that much more because we was like, so, whenever we wasn't getting along with leaders, which normally happens with brothers, I would always run to Queens and go hang out with Q-Tip and Phife. Or I would just go to a couple of blocks away from my bed because Jerome was in Hempstead with us. And they always let me come in the house. And they always let me sleep over. Let me come to every studio session. Even when I wasn't allowed to be there, I show up anyway. And they let me in. That's why I ended up on so many Tribe songs.
Thank you. changed his mind. But he said, yes, we're supposed to be on this record. Money changed. That song changed my money. Changed my ability to provide for my family. It allowed me to be a good father, a great son, securing and taking on the responsibility of securing the well-being of my house, like many others, directly and indirectly. I'm forever in debt to Tribe. Everything plays out as an effect by what was caused to create the effect. So if they didn't do that for me and leaders, maybe I would be a different dude today. I just know that the world stopped for me when they all agreed for us to be on that record. Kamal said, "You're gonna last." And at that time, going last was like getting a championship belt. With all of that being said, I just want to thank my brother, Malik Taylor, Phife Dog, the 5 foot assassin, Marty Rance, for being the big brother that I needed, especially at a very crucial turning point and crossroads in my life. Once again, thank you, Mama Phife, Daddy Phife, Wife Phife. Love y'all very much.
Yeah, later on, we followed each other, you know, and stayed in touch, and it's just an amazing, amazing loss. I couldn't believe that when I heard it. I know he's in a better place, buying his next jersey, looking down on everybody. But Phife and the Tribe is one of the great MCs and one of the great groups of all time. Much respect.
I just want to say rest in peace to Phife. You know, I'm an NBA player, but I'm a huge music fan. I do a lot of rapping on my own time, and he was before my time, but like I said, being a huge music fan, I definitely followed his music, Q-Tip, Tribe Called Quest, and you know, I was a huge fan. I would have loved to have the opportunity to work with him. I saw a video a couple months ago where he said I was the best rapper in the league and that he would love to work with me, and I was actually looking forward to that. I know he had been living in the Bay Area, and I'm from the Bay Area. It's sad to know that I didn't get that opportunity to work with one of the legends, you know, one of the pioneers in the rap game. But I really wish the best for the family. My condolences are with you guys. It's a sad day for hip hop. And a tough loss for everybody.
Just in honor of Phife Dawg, you know, just wanted to pay my respect. You know, obviously, huge in the industry. Respect everything you did, big fan. Definitely want to, you know, say sorry for your loss to his family, you know, and just continue to stay prayed up and believe.
Say, brothers front. They say the Tribe can't flow. We've been known to do the impossible like Broadway Joe. Phife Dawg, crazy rapper, crazy fan. Of all athletics, a great human being. We got many chances to spend time together. And I know I bothered you about rap and all the greats and asking many questions and sports. Me and you will go back and forth arguing on the same. The presence is gonna be missed. Peace to the Tribe. We love you. We love the Tribe. It hurts that we'll never be able to hear you again in person. You know you're up in heaven making beats, making music, making the angels bob back and forth. Phife, we love you. The whole sporting community love you. It was real.
There it goes. Rest in peace, Phife. Love you, man. My dog. I want to thank Tribe Called Quest. I want to thank Phife's parents. And thank you for making me a part of Low End Theory. Yeah. Love y'all. Y'all are my friends.
Ladies and gentlemen, Consequence. Oh, man. What up, everybody? Queens is in the building, Harlem's in the building. Word. Since my cousin Kamal called me and told me what happened to Phife, it's kind of been like a little hollow inside of me because there's no way to properly articulate what Phife meant in my life. He was the first person to take me to Atlanta. I was just getting out of high school, and we were just on Beachron's Life, and he had this thing called Phife Night and at the Velvet Room in Atlanta, and I was like, so from Queens, I didn't understand Atlanta. What's Atlanta? How do you get there? You need a space shuttle? Not to mention the fact that I just had never experienced somebody tell me that they would pay for a plane ticket for me with no strings attached. That's the kind of spirit that Phife had. And it was a lot for Phife with me because, you know, I was basically like scrappy coming into Scooby-Doo land. You know what I'm saying? Like, he was the guy with the punchlines, and he literally passed the torch to me. And he had to. He chose to. You know, he saw what I embodied on behalf of Queens, and he applauded it, and he helped nurture it. Obviously, as well as did Q-Tip and Ali at the time. So, you know, for me, it's just, this year would be the 20th anniversary of Beast Rhymes and Life. And this is so, it's so sad for me. It really is, because these are the guys who gave me any, whatever you want to call it, look, celebrity. You know, I'm a kid from Queens. I'm a kid from the cleaners. I'm from 192. You know what I'm saying? And I just want to rep with the crew from 192 that I seen do it. Because my family changed the world. My family changed hip hop. You know what I'm saying? And my whole thing with, from the time of the announcement of his death until today, I just wanted the world to know that this is legendary.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Like, this is legendary. This is meant to be undervalued, understated, underappreciated in no sense of the word. So for me, I haven't properly grieved yet because I've really been in that space. I want everybody to honor my family. That's what I want. You know, I want the family that brought me into the rap game, I want them to be honored. So I appreciate the turnout. I wanted to speak on behalf of Tribe, on behalf of Queens. I appreciate everything that everybody has said about Phife. Obviously, all condolences go to Deesh, all condolences go to his parents. You know what I'm saying? And I just, you know, on behalf of Queens, I just know that, like, you know, this is a tough one for us, but we're gonna get through it. And rest in peace to my dog, Phife Dawg.
I know that, first of all the people, the regular fans that came, I know Phife would be so appreciative. And he would be like, yo, they came, fam? So, I'm just humbled to have done anything. You know, I'm a fan, you know, and that's why I wanted to make the movie in the first place. And you know, I had known Ali a little bit, and I had known Q-Tip a little bit before we started making the movie, and I didn't know Phife, and you know, you know, the first time we interviewed with him, I was like, it was as if I was interviewing Paul McCartney or Keith Richards or something. Like, I was like so nervous, and you know, and I didn't know what he was gonna say. I didn't know what he wasn't gonna say. I was intimidated by this little short guy. And, you know, he gave his heart and soul as soon as he started talking. And I remember the first time, you know, he talked about Deisha and he talked about what he was going through. And, you know, there was no, you know, I know that, like, I never had the courage to call him Malik because I was always such a fan. Even as we became friendly, I was just like, you know, it's Phife Dawg from A Tribe Called Quest. Like, I just always like, that's Phife. I didn't plan on anything specific. You know, I feel like, you know, there's so many things that, you know, have been going through my head listening to everybody talk. I wonder if up until last night, God had a chance to meet Phife intimately, but I'm sure after North Carolina lost that game, he probably was made well aware of this guy. That's the first thing that came into my mind was, he must have just been going bananas. There's so many people in here that I'm fans of, and I'll just say this, you know, I'm surprised there hasn't been any girls up here talking, because one thing that I was always impressed and taken aback by, and it was he would refer to this person or that person, this girl and that girl as my friend. Oh, you gotta speak to so-and-so, she's my friend. You gotta speak to so-and-so, she's my best friend. You know, and I was always like, this is a good dude. Like, you know, he's got like, cause you know, guys, you know, we aren't mature enough to have that. So I don't know. You know, a couple of us put together a little video just to celebrate Phife. And, you know, my heart goes out to his family and his close friends and, you know, to Deisha. And, you know, I'll tell you one thing, you know, another thing, when we were making that movie, he would literally cry tears numerous times talking about you and what you meant to him. And remember one time he was like, you know, you can't use that shit, fam. And I was like, no, we won't use anything. Because to me, I'm talking to Keith Richards. Like, I'm like, and then he would say, you know, you could use whatever you want. But like, it was a common occurrence where he would literally cry talking about you and what you meant to him. So we put together a little thing, I'm proud to have gotten to know him, and I'm proud that collectively, you know the guys in the group know, you know, I'm a fan, and that we were able to put something that, you know, hopefully, you know, more fans could get a slice of insight into what this guy was like, because at the end of the day, he was, you know, there was no separation between, you know, like, Phife the character and Malik the person, you felt like you knew that person. And there was no put-ons. He was exactly what he said he was in the music. And that's, you know, a special thing. And I think that's one of the reasons why, you know, the music and Phife Dawg, the character within the group, will be around longer than all of us. So I hope you enjoy this, and you know, my thoughts and prayers are for everybody here.
At the end of the day, we make mistakes. I definitely made my shit. I'm definitely not perfect, but we just had talent that God gave us, and we made do with what we had. Whatever it is you want to do, whatever it is you want to be, there's no such thing as can't.
You know what? Let's freestyle a little bit.
Uh-oh.
I knew that was coming. We might as well, you know. If that's where it all comes from, give me a tempo.
Let me hear the beat or something.
Yeah.
Alright. Fight. Kick it off, man. Kick it off. Yo, check it. Check it. I wanna play the crowd. Check it. Was everybody's out your seats and over the wall? It's the fight, Dinky Dog, on us in your hall. Kick your rhymes, kick your beats, just strictly for the streets. And if it's Burger King, well then I suggest you eat. A little hip hop, up the tip and the top of the dome. Make the sucker MCs wanna go home. Whether you're from that place or whether you're from this place, I'm straight from New York, but Atlanta is my main place. Check out the style as I kick it like whatever. My rhyme style is ill, plus my brothers is quite clever. So check it how I kick it one time for your mind. Rough Daddy crew coming through. Yo, check them out.
Shit alone. You be a fool to reply to Phife, he's not the man. Cause you know, and I know that you know who I am. You're coming to your own as an MC, you know what I'm saying? So, I had this stupid little high-pitched voice. I hated my voice. But, everybody else seemed to like it, so you can't fight the fans. You don't want to do that. That's basically how Roman came about. We just clicked. Everything was clicking. Everything was right.
In making the Roman theory, there's definitely, you know, what I think is evident to everyone, and that's the emergence of Phife Diggy Dog.
These cats know I'm going to be forced to be reckoned with. A lot of people don't have that passion.
Let's get it. shall not all sleep. We shall be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. When your absence from this body, your presence with the Lord. I'm gonna sing Angel, your treasure, of his lovely wife, who he talked about many, many times. God bless you. Yeah.
show our respect to a fellow MC that was a true MC. When we talk about Phife out here, let me tell you, man, Grandmaster Flash.
What?
47 years ago, it was just a thought. How do I take the tools that I had at the time? How do I take what I had and convert it to make it what it needs to be? I can sit here for hours and break down the science, but I won't do that. You see, it's moments like these. No one realizes they're in history until it's too late. Every day this is history. Every move we make, our history. First time I ever saw a fight, it was a place called Car Wash. Down in the Lower East Side. Raw MCs, hungry in the belly. We all sitting around looking at each other like, who are you? Who are you? Tribe Called Quest stepped up, dropped the whole. Yo, there's only a few MCs that could go on after KRS, okay? That's one of them right there. Busta Rhymes, zone, man, come on. There's only a few.
Break it down, Chris.
That I truly kneel to. Truly. So I'm gonna do Phife's favorite record right now. It's called Still Number One. Yo, Quest, can I get some drums? drums, man? Yo, Quest, where you at, man?
Quest left, I think.
Yo.
Hold on.
Nah, he's still here. The drum's still here.
The drum's still here?
Drum's still here. Quest's still here.
Where the drum sticks?
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Take three on the drums, y'all.
Let's go. 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 Turn the drums up. Turn the drums up and out so we can hear it. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Ooh, you doing it like that? All right, watch this. Freestyle off the top, this how it go. If you with me now, somebody say, y'all better keep up. KRS here, got Capri on the cut. I'm sorry, the drums. Let me tell you right now, I'm doing this one for Phife one. I'ma tell you right now, Phife is the paint. When I say the paint, I mean great. When I say great, I mean we should raise Phife door up to the level of a saint. I got the picture on the wall. He sets the Molly Mall. One for the treble, two for the bass. You keep going, I'm spitting out my face. You gotta see what it is. I'ma say this to all the kids. Listen how he did. Tribe Called Quest, from the east, not the west. This is how we do it with KRS. My man Phife Dawg, I tell you it's a token. The last time I saw Phife was in Oakland. I was doing a show, he came through. Let me tell you how the whole crew do. Some MCs, they sit in the crowd. Other MCs, you give them the mic, they make it loud. My man Phife did his whole bit. KRS-One, I rap, I don't sing. So I'ma be out with King Capri, Teddy Ted, Special K, and John.
Oh, man.
They did it wrong, so I didn't say it. Grandmaster Flash, you first to play it. If it wasn't for you, there'd be no me or him or him or him.
King Capri, learn up.
So let's get going. KRS freestyle blowing, and I'm out because my time is up. Yo, what up, Phife Dawg? We holding you up.
Rest in peace to Phife Dawg. Tribe Called Quest, one of the greatest dudes to ever touch the mic. Ever, forever, forever, and ever, and ever, and ever. Tribe Called Quest, you see what I'm wearing, right? You see what I'm wearing? Let me just say, Tribe Called Quest. Forever linked to Phife Dawg, cause he was the one that said try to make hits like Kid Capri makes tapes. I'm out.
Woo! Big up, respect to the whole family. I did a record just about 2 hours ago. I spit something for Phife. You might hear it on the internet. I'm calling all MCs in the entire industry to spit 16 for Phife. Throw the money to the family. Peace.